Hey everybody, it's me, CyberGwar. How my favorite people doing? I'm just gonna make a little video here to show you guys some like little known tips and tricks here in Star Citizen. None of these things are like major money makers or anything like that. Some of them are no money makers at all. Some of them show you how to spend money. But we're gonna go through it. A lot of people, you know, they're rushing through here, or they don't know what they're doing. They're brand new players. It's kind of what this is geared to, or they don't know about little Easter eggs that are hidden about this verse. So I'm just gonna make this little series of tips. I'll try and do like 10 or 12 in each video. I'll try and keep them short too. So we're gonna get started here, but I need a cup of coffee first. So if you ever need coffee in Microtech, or not Microtech, Area 18, you need to put your little cup there and have it fill it up for you. Usually there's a cup on there, there's a cup in the sink. I want to thank all our channel members who support the content creation on this channel. Thank you so much for your continued support, and to all our channel subscribers. All right, we got coffee. We have almost 1,500 subscribers, so if you haven't done so yet, please hit the subscribe button, and we're going to get going here. Get right to it. I'm not going to talk your ears off today. Here's our first tip. For starters, when you're in your room, when you start out in your room, there's a lot of things in here you could grab. Like, look at that. And you can just store it in your local inventory. As you can see, I got a bunch of stuff in here. But you just grab it and drag it there. There's some cool stuff here, like, inside there. Like, you can get that one, but that other one fell back there. I'll show you how to get that in a second. You just hit I to open your inventory, and then you can rotate the camera, clip it right through the cabinet. Where am I at? There we are. And then you can just grab it. Wham! Okay, there's another one there I wouldn't be able to get without using this little inventory cheat. I don't know if it's a cheat, but it's a thing that's in game I can use that. Oh, look at that. We got more stuff back here. We just drag it in. It's the stuff that's inside the wall there. I think it's supposed to be in the drawer, but just for whatever reason, the server forced it to move. All these books. Some more cleaner. And then once you get the stuff in your inventory, you can set up your ship to make it look like you actually live in it. Look, there's another one there. You got little packs of food, little condiments, little glasses. Yeah, so after you take the stuff out of your room, you know, you can just kind of set it up in your little galley or around your ship, whatever you want. It makes it look like you kind of live there. All right, tip number 9. When you're at the commons, a new Babbage, you go to the factory line, and you got a couple floors of shopping here. A lot of people don't know about this place. You can buy new Mobi glasses here. You can buy some technology here, like new hacking chips. Oh, actually, it's all the same hacking chips right here from these little kiosks. You can get Tiger Claws, but you can get new Mobi glasses here too. It's pretty cool. And if you want to check them out, they got them on display. You know, they got different colored ones, sand, woodland, charcoal. I'm going to buy woodland since that's what I'm wearing right now. Confirm purchase. Exacto. And I think it appears in utility. Yeah, right here in utility. And you just drag it. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna double click on it, see if it installs it. Yeah, so now I have the woodland one on. There we go. See, all right. And then you see, I have a new Mobi glass, a new color, other than the standard like grayish one. Pretty cool, huh? They got other tech here. They got the Mobi glasses. They got hacking chips. They got eye augmentation for like the AR stuff that you see. These are contact lenses. Eventually, these will be in your eyeballs. It's like, look, you got consumer products and then an amphitheater down here. Down here, they have holo tables and maps. This is all stuff you'll have in your hangar. They have different avionics for your ships. You'll be able to come here and buy different components. So you got different power units, stuff like that. It's gonna be really cool. Look at holo projectors. It's what they use in to display the holograms around New Babbage. Eventually, you'll be able to put those in your ship or your home or whatever. These are like the blades for the AI you're gonna put in your ship. That they will man turrets and handle systems and stuff if you're crewing ships by yourself, multi-crew ships by yourself. You got your ship diagnostic cart that you'll be able to take into your hangar, and it'll tell you all the things wrong with your ship. You'll be able to fine-tune things. Here we got the map tables, hologram tables. You'll be able to display planets and systems that you want to look at. Yeah, holo spheres. I mean, these are the things that you'll have for missions and stuff on the huge ships. And things like the Carrick for mapping systems, for planning battles. Here we have the Muse Simpods. Eventually, you'll have these in your ships. So when you're on really long voyages, or you'll have them in your homes too. You can just climb in there and go play Arena Commander and Star Marine and stuff like that. Theaters of War, if that's ever finished. And you'd be able to go in there and do that on long flights. So you just don't have to sit in your ship for the whole time. Or you'd be able to video conference with people. Who knows what else? Maybe play chess or other things virtually with people. I don't know. They got a whole bunch of stuff planned for them. You also have arcade games on board and pool tables, chess and checkerboards. So it's not gonna be totally boring when you're out in the void traveling for hours on end, jumping multiple systems. So a lot of cool stuff here, Microtech. You may not have ever seen, may not have ever known this was a place here, because the stairwell is in the floor. So this brings us right back up to the top here. This is in the center of the commons. Also at the commons, but when you go towards from the metro, if you go towards the promenade here, you got a surface entrance here. That before you go down the tunnel to the promenade there, you can actually take this to go upstairs and get a land vehicle and go out on the ice. So this is the entrance from the commons that people, when they land on the ice, they come in here. Never seen a garden here before. Yeah, so look at all these people land out here on the ice. And they come in here instead of going to the spaceport. And we got a garage right here. You can actually pull a vehicle out and put it in your ship. So here's your fleet manager for ground vehicles. And then it'll pop up in this garage right here. And then you just request to leave from the ground services, vehicle services, and they'll open the door for you, just like a ship. And then over here in this little storage closet, ooh, they redid it. Wow, it wasn't like this before. Or was it? Oh, it looks much bigger. But over here, they got the hidden Pico. It's been here for a while. It's been here since New Babbage was put in the game. All right, then here at New Babbage is the surface entrance from the inside the spaceport right here. That takes you down to the garages that is close to the spaceport where you can load up vehicles. All right, number 7. A lot of the spaceports have rental offices. So this is the one here at New Babbage, but there's also ones at Hurston, Orison, and Area 18. And they have some ships for rent. So if you're ever stranded or you want to try something out like a game loop, You know, you can come rent the ship for the day. You know, you can like rent a Constellation Phoenix or an Andromeda, like the gunship. And you can rent out, I think, land vehicles. No, not here. But I know over at the Lagrange points, they have the refineries. You can rent Cutlass Blacks and rocks and go out rock mining for the day and make some money. You'll actually make your money back if you go out and do some mining. Or if you just want to try out a ship for a little bit before you go and buy one. Like, this is 13,958 credits for one day rental, and I think this thing costs like 250,000. But you're not sure if you'd like it or not, you can always just rent it for the day and go test drive it. Yeah, that's a little thing. A lot of new players don't know about that. And it's right over here by the Picos in New Babbage. Otherwise, just look for the signs. I know at Lorville, it's right by the Lorville sign in the spaceport. At Ortisan, it's right down the stairs as you're going to the elevators for the tram. You go to the shuttle. Area 18. Oh man, I don't know where it is at Area 18 off the top of my head. But it's there. And then, of course, at the refinery decks and cargo decks, too, I think, have them. So the refinery decks and cargo decks both have rental areas as well at all the stations. Our next little hidden feature or cool thing. Right here, out here on this island. It's just a little Easter egg. In fact, there's two Easter eggs I'm going to show you here. This is the first of the two Easter eggs. So you come into this island here on the frozen lake in front in New Babbage. It's in between the spaceport and the commons. So you want to look up for this little tiny little outcropping here. So it's like directly across from this little structure when you land on the other side of the ship here. Somebody set up some chairs, a beer keg, and some beers out here. Looks like a little radio. I don't know what was going on here. There's got to be some kind of lore or meaning behind it, but it's a little Easter egg. You got little teddy bears out here, and they just sit out here looking at the city for whatever. Maybe it's for the fireworks show that they have every year for IEE. Okay, so the second part of the Easter egg, a lot of people know about this, but new players might not know. And this is kind of what this whole little video is about, is for new players. But if you follow the tracks under the nest from the spaceport, you can actually fly underneath the nest. I think I'm gonna land my ship. I think it might be too big in there. This is why I always have a land vehicle on board. All right, so if you land your vehicle, if you got a big vehicle, I recommend landing out here and driving or walking in. Ursa is usually a little better for this than a Stevie, because the geometry is all messed up here. Man, they really cut down the Stevie's power, and it cannot handle hills at all. If CIG would just implement a throttle for your land vehicles, we wouldn't have a lot of problems with the land vehicles like we do. I don't know why they never did. And they seem perplexed on how to install one. All right, so then eventually you'll get here. Little Christmas tree here under the nest, under the hospital. Really cool. I suggest if you've never been here, you come check it out. All right, and now we are at our next little area above Hurston. And if you look down a part of Hurston, you see that it's like red, orange, green, yellow. These are the acid fields of Hurston. Yeah, this is on Hurston, so most of Hurston does not look like this. In fact, this looks just like Ariel, except I haven't found any geysers here. Ariel has geysers coming out of these rocks. These like they look like termite mounds, but I mean, I'm not saying there's not geysers out here on Hurston, but I haven't seen any. These things are on Ariel too, these little primordial pools here. Used to be able to leave your footprints in them. I don't know if that's just not working on this server or what, but I was out here not too long ago. I was able to leave my footprints in here. Sometimes they shut things off like footprints and little things you don't notice just to help with resources. Yeah, I highly recommend you come and check this place out. It's pretty cool. Also, go check out Ariel. There's a whole planet, a whole moon looks just like this. So when you get to a shop kiosk and you want to buy and sell stuff, you can just literally select where you want to send it. I want to buy some armor, but I don't want to wear it. I want to put it in my ship and I want to bring it with me because my friend is stranded on a planet only in a flight suit and needs some armor. So I'm going to just transfer it right to the ship. I'm gonna buy this and it's gonna go the destination to my ship, or I can even put it in one of the boxes I have aboard. So I know I have one of these store all boxes. I have a container there. I have a 1A SKU, and as long as it fits, you can send it there. Same thing goes for your backpack or even clothing I may have here at Everest Harbor. So I got these Cumulus pants that are brown. Here, we'll send a med pen over there, quick buy. And then when I open my inventory and I select clothing here at Everest, these are the pants I just sent the med pen to. And I open its inventory by clicking this little button here on the left. And right there, that's the med pen. Extremely simple. You can buy and sell the same way. So to sell stuff, you can sell from your local inventory. You can sell from all your clothing. Here, I got that med pen in there. I'm gonna quick sell that. No, it's not in those pants. Same thing goes with your ship. I'm in my ship. I know I have a container full of weapons I wanna sell actually here, because you get twice the amount of money for your P4s here. And I come across these in bunkers all the time. You get 2,000 here versus like 1,000 everywhere else. And it's as simple as that. And just, you sell away. And now I'm taking it out of that container. I didn't have to move anything around in inventories. Makes it really simple, really fast. I don't know how this will change when we have our hangers, but let's hope it still stays pretty functional like this. It's pretty nice. All right, here's a little tip. Say you're in Armistice Zone and you see a weapon on the ground, or you dropped your weapon and you can't pick it up. Here, look, like it won't let me pick it up. Just hit I for your inventory, and look at this, it'll highlight. You can just drag it right there. Just click and drag, and then bring it right into your inventory, or you can put it right on your back, right up here. I'm not going to add it because I have a weapon up there already, but you can add it right to your back and then go along your day. All right, so if you're a new player and you come across these guys with the vest, you want to loot them and put their vest in your backpack. Take it back to a cassava and sell it. It's worth 2,400 credits. Okay, and my final tip is always be dressed and prepared for whatever it is you are going to do. If you look at me, I'm always dressed to the nines to go assault and kick some butt, do some bunker busting, because that's what I love to do. Plus, I'm in an org. We tend to get in some firefights. I always have a backpack. I always have my sidearm. I always have ammo for that sidearm and my primary rifle. I usually carry at least one grenade, sometimes a flare. Multi-tool med gun and med pens are non-negotiable. Always have those on you. They come in handy for reviving teammates, reviving strangers. Tractor beams are great for transferring cargo, moving things around, pulling people out of the danger zone if they are incapacitated, and then zapping them so you don't have to go into enemy fire. I always have backup med paramed refill. If you look here, like, my refill is almost empty, and when it gets empty and runs out, it'll just pull right from there. Then I'll have a backup in my core armor. Usually I have ammo for my rifle, a couple tiger claws for hacking terminals in case I get a crime stat or I have to go shut down a com array. I have extra med pens. I tend to avoid the med pen usage as much as possible, since it makes your blood toxicity levels rise. I always have a mining head, orbit mining attachment. That's what it's called. just in case I want to do some hand mining while I'm out, or if I need to go do the clear all the narcotic missions, you can actually use that to pop those things. It's pretty easy. And then I always have water. I always have a water and a couple things of food just to get me through until I can get somewhere. Or if I do get stranded, I'm not gonna die of food and thirst. I usually always have an oxy pen with me too, but the oxygen thing I don't think is working right now. The detox pen. They're on my ship, I know that for sure. I have a couple in my Jeep, but yeah. Oh, anytime I take my helmet off, I put it in my backpack. I do not put it in a local inventory. I do not put it in the ship inventory. It's always in my backpack. So in case I forget to put it back on and I walk outside the ship, or I fall out of the ship or whatever, and I start convulsing, I can just open eye real quick, double click on it, and stick it right back on my head, and I'll usually survive. All right, everyone, that's it. That's it. I am out of here. I hope you guys enjoy this video. I'll probably do a few more tip videos eventually as we go, but no rhyme or reason to them. They're just different things I was thinking of as I was walking around the verse. All right, I'm out. Peace. That's for you guys. I'm gone. See you later.